Hey guys, Drifter here, welcome to World War II In-Depth. In today's episode, we're going to be talking about the new shotgun buffs, sniper rifle nerfs, changes to the FG-42, grease gun, and the overall big January update as it pertains to weapons. Got a lot to talk about today, and I've got some great gameplay to share with you, so let's jump right into it with the shotgun changes. The damage range on the combat shotgun was nerfed, and the damage range on the double barrel shotgun was buffed. Of note, the change on the combat shotgun was minimal, probably unnoticeable at best, and the change on the double barrel shotgun is extremely noticeable. So I'm going to go ahead and show you the range at which it will and will not one shot as pertains to the combat shotgun. It is actually still getting hit markers at that range, and I feel like before the patch I probably would have been able to kill somebody. However, will J-Hub's health regenerate, and at this range, pop, he is dead. I also set the health regeneration to faster in case you're wondering why I shot him so quickly. Still an impressive range, not the greatest range. When it comes to the double barrel shotgun, the one-shot kill range is not very good looking, at least compared to the combat and the Luftwaffe drilling, but it will get a one-shot kill at this range, which previously was just downright terrible. I mean, it basically got double the amount of range, and it seems to have an increased amount of damage on the pellets and on the flat damage as well, so your ability to just tap-tap two-shot people is more like the Luftwaffe drilling or the combat shotgun and less like the old confetti cannon that it used to be. The double barrel shotgun also got its reload speed buff to 2.3 seconds or 1.5 seconds when you're running Hustle like I am in most of these clips. Hustle is just a godsend, and this one now seems to reload faster than the Luftwaffe drilling, so it does definitely have a place in the meta. It's got a higher base damage than the Luftwaffe drilling, and it reloads faster, so the drilling is going to be more like your long range one shot weapon. This one's going to be your two tap and go home kind of weapon as far as I can tell. Unfortunately, the double barrel shotgun did get a major hip fire nerf, one that even requires a video example for me to show you. This is me walking around just a little bit wiggling with the double barrel shotgun so you can get an idea of just how enormous the hip fire is when I'm not running steady aim. And I run steady aim in most of the clips, so I just wanted to show you this. I'm going to go ahead and stop, and I'll show you standing still and then crouched and then prone, and you'll notice it has the same STG-44 bug of transitioning. I'm going to go ahead and do three shots, one crouched, one standing, which God bless, look at that spread. I just had to stop in the middle of the testing to kind of eyeball that and see how crazy it is. And then one more when I decide to go ahead and aim down sights. When I move closer, you can see that there is a colossal difference in the spreads, with standing still being terrible, prone being okay, and aim down sights by far being the way to go. When it comes to the combat shotgun now, I would tell you to treat it like the Luftwaffe drilling and aim down sights 100% of the time, and it will be a much better weapon. Moving along to the grease gun. Let's talk about the grease gun aim down sights time buff. It got buffed to 200 milliseconds from 250 milliseconds, so it got 50 milliseconds faster. When you run quick draw on it, it's incredibly fast at 125 milliseconds. So the grease gun is a very, very snappy weapon now. You can just snap targets incredibly quickly, and it makes it feel pretty good. The grease gun also got a recoil buff for, quote, more player control. This is a small buff, as I could not test for it due to the inputs, and it didn't feel very impactful. My guess means that this is changing one of two variables in the game. One is a variable that controls random recoil or random amounts of kick, and if that variable is really high, it just shakes all over the place. Another one is there is a recoil bonus, or the next shot will decrease, and it allows you to fight the recoil. If the player is currently fighting the direction of the recoil, you get less with each shot. It's kind of a strange mechanic they added in Black Ops 3, but either one of those could have been changed, and it'll make it feel slightly better, maybe. Honestly, I didn't notice. And since the aim down sights time got buffed, I went ahead and checked sprint out time. Sprint out time is still 250 milliseconds, so when you're running around with the grease gun, if you aim down sights, there may be a delay before you can pull the trigger, which is frustrating. But if you're walking or standing still, you can just snap aim people super, super quickly. A very important topic to talk about is the FG-42. On launch, the FG-42 had 517 rounds per minute when it came to rate of fire. That put the little asterisk up there because that was coded, not measured in game. The old FG-42, as of a couple days ago, fired at 447 rounds per minute, and the new one got a super tiny fire rate increase to 460. This was a micro adjustment. Most of you probably won't notice the difference, and it said it got reduced recoil in this patch, significantly, supposedly. It was never bad before, it was still good now. This is another recoil adjustment that I was neither able to test for nor notice in game. I mean, you tell me, that's not bad recoil. recoil. It's a little bit vertical, but you should be able to fight that very, very easily. Moving along to the sniper rifles, the Kar-98 aim down sights time got nerfed. It was 350 milliseconds, now it's a little bit slower at 400 milliseconds. The Lee Enfield got an aim down sights time buff. It was 400, now 350. These two sniper rifles have roughly traded places, so you can't aim down sights quite as quickly on the Kar-98, and you can do it more quickly on the Lee Enfield, which I think is fair, given that the Kar-98 can one-shot more than the Lee Enfield. That feels like a nice swap, and I tested sniper sprint out times are unchanged. So quick scoping won't get any easier with either of those weapons. It's still going to be the exact same level of difficulty. And when it comes to my overall thoughts, summary, conclusion, whatever you want to call that about this patch, the sawed-off shotgun is now a ton better. I'm really glad I waited to do my diamond challenges on that one later because, oh my god, that's just going to be, you're going to get so many more one-shot kills with this weapon. It still may not be a top-tier shotgun, but my god, is it going to be better. The grease gun is now more unique. It's not super better or worse, it's just more unique. It's got a more interesting feel to it. The FG42 is slightly better, ever so slightly, and the snipers have been rebalanced. They're not inherently better or worse, they've just kind of been rebalanced a little bit, and that's okay by me. Guys, that is all for this short patch notes video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something useful. If you did, don't forget to like, favorite, and subscribe. Drifter out. If you want all the weapon stats for World War II in your pocket to go, then look no further than the Ultimate Utility app by Brass Monkey. It's available on iOS and Android. There are links in the description, or you can just search for it in the App Store.